Hey there, I've got some great news. TechSmith's Camtasia 2018 now allows us to set up and maintain color palettes under what they are calling themes. Today we're going to discuss what I consider to be one of the best tools for creating color palettes and then how to use and manage those color palettes in Camtasia 2018 themes for editing your videos. I'm Naomi Skorzynski with the Top Shelf VA channel, your place for inspiration and creativity for your business and life. So if you want to continue learning with my eclectic assortment of training videos, make sure to hit the subscribe button and that notification bell. So let's go ahead and get into it. To fully understand using and managing Camtasia 2018 themes, we are going to learn in a specific order and thought process. This will help make setting up your Camtasia theme palettes a breeze as you follow along. So first, we're going to discuss the mindset of branding. Second, we'll learn how to create color palettes using my favorite tool. Third, we are going to learn how to manage the setup of the Camtasia 2018 themes. And fourth, we're going to see how we can use the Camtasia 2018 themes for editing our videos. And last but not least, a bonus of some workflow tips when working with Camtasia 2018 themes. Branding covers a whole gamut of theories and criteria. For our purposes, we're focusing on branding as far as what people will consistently see. More than likely, you'll be handling one of three types of brands, or maybe all three. There is the branding for your company or your YouTube channel. This is specific to what will be consistent for your company or your YouTube channel across all platforms of social media, print, and videos. Then there will be branding for a specific video project. It's the brand that must be consistent for that specific video, but not necessarily any other videos you may be producing. And then, of course, last, if you create videos for clients as I do in my business, you will have clients branding, which is specific to their businesses. Now, before we jump directly into setting up the Camtasia 2018 themes, it's much better for us to work out the color branding and have a color palette developed for our purposes first. So let's move on to the fun part, or what I think is the fun part, and create our color palettes. Now, my absolute favorite tool for creating color palettes for video or anything to do with design is Adobe Color CC. You can find this at color.adobe.com. I'll have the link for you in the description below. You could create your initial color palette in Camtasia 2018. However, I find this tool will give you a better, full-scale, automated, at-a-glance idea of what your palette colors will look like side by side. With this tool, you can use the color wheel exclusively, you can work from an image, or my favorite, use an image and the color wheel in conjunction with each other. So let's first look at the layout of the color wheel side of things so you understand it better. The color wheel itself you can minimize or expand with a click. There are five color boxes under the wheel representing the five colors selected in the wheel. The base color the wheel works from has a white triangle. There are four adjustment bars. The first three are your RGB adjustments, and the fourth is your shade adjustment where you are adding black to the color to make the shade. Underneath the bars are the RGB and the hex code of the color in the box above it. The wheel itself. The outside of the wheel is the full saturated hue of the color. As you go into the center of the wheel, you are adding white, which is called the tint of the color. These color arms, for a lack of a better term, can be easily moved. To the left of the wheel is a drop-down to select the color harmony. Now, we won't go into the full color theory, but here's a short synopsis of what each means. Analogous are colors that are usually close to each other. Monochromatic colors are different tints and shades of a specific color or hue. Triads are three main colors equally spaced around the color wheel. Complementary colors sit opposite of each other on the color wheel. Compound, or what is also known as split complementary, is using colors opposite each other on the side of a specific hue.
or color.
Shades is simply the amount of black that was added to the original hue or color.
As you work with setting up your color palette, always keep in mind how you might be using these colors. For instance, what is the color of the text font that you want? What is going to be your main color? What are your background colors? Colors for your accents? The five colors you're seeing in the boxes, how pleasing are they to the eye? Now that we understand the color wheel tool, let's get at my favorite way of creating color palettes, using an image and the color wheel together.
Click on Import Image and import an image from your hard drive. You can go through the Change Color Mood drop-down and select a different mood. If you want, you can click on one of the color boxes to select it and move the corresponding circle to a color a little more to your liking. Now, before we move back to the color wheel, let's select a different picture. You can change the picture by clicking on the current picture and selecting another one from your hard drive. One of the easiest things to do for consistency for your business or your channel is to use the masthead from your YouTube channel or your website. I'll use my TopShelf VA channel masthead as an example here. I'll move these circles to colors I want to start with by clicking on the squares and their corresponding circles, and then move those circles around to what I like. Okay, now that I am close to what I want from the picture, I'll move back to the color wheel. And as you can see, my color palette from the picture carried over here. I'll start with this red as I want more of an orange from my palette. I'll use the arms, the RGB, and the shades to get what I want. I'll also want this blue to be a darker blue. So for each of the colors, I will simply adjust the RGB slides and the shade as needed. Possibly the arms, though that's usually the last when I add some white to a color. And now I have my main color palette. You can save it in your Adobe account if you have one, or simply take a snapshot of it with Snagit or another screenshot software and save it to your hard drive. You'll see why saving your color palettes to your hard drive is a good idea when we get into Camtasia 2018. I also suggest making two more palettes, one of lighter tints of your palette by adding the white to the hue and dragging the arm straight down from each color, and then one of the darker shades by adding black on the bottom adjustment bar for each color. Make sure to take a snapshot of the lighter color palette and the darker color palette and save those to your hard drive. Okay, now we're on to the simpler task of setting up these color palettes as Camtasia 2018 themes. The first thing I'm going to do is load each of my saved color palettes into the media bin and put them at the bottom of the canvas. I'll be using these as a guide for easy setup of the themes. Click on File, then Manage Themes. Let me move this to the side so I have room to show you some training notes. Here's one reason why I like creating the color palettes in Adobe Color CC. The colors are right next to each other. Visually, this gives a better understanding how the colors will affect the eye. In the Camtasia 2018 Theme Manager, with the dark gray background and the white border around each color, it is harder to know immediately how the colors would work together side by side. As we see here, when opening the Theme Manager for the first time, the theme is called Default, and these are Camtasia's or TechSmith's Camtasia colors. We also have labels for each of these, which at first can seem confusing. Why didn't they simply call it Color 1 through 5? Well, once I figured it out, I realized there actually is a specific thought process behind this. Here's how to think of it. Think of foreground as the text color you most often use. Yes, you can use the other colors for other text, but this foreground is the color that will be used immediately or automatically when selecting this theme, unless you decide to manually change the font color later. You'll see in a minute. The two background colors are exactly what they are. Background 1 is what I think of as the background color I most often use. As with the foreground color, I'm thinking of background 1 as the color that will be used immediately or automatically when selecting this theme for all solid-filled annotation backgrounds. Accent 1 and accent 2 are probably best thought of as the colors you believe you would use most often for the drawing annotations, possibly borders or lines and arrows. Let's create our first theme. Click on the drop-down box, click on Rename Theme, and give it a new name. I'll call this TSVA palette, as this will be my main theme. I usually use white for my text, so I will change this from the drop-down and color picker to a pure white. For my background, I normally use this base blue on most of my call-out annotations. I'll use the eyedropper and select the color from my saved Adobe Color CC palette down here. The other color I use quite often for my background is the purple. So drop down, eyedropper, and select the purple. I use the green and orange most often for my drawing annotations. I'll click on the plus sign to add the orange. The annotation background is what I was referring to as what I want to automatically use whenever I select this Camtasia 2018 theme, so I'll change that to the blue. You'll see the only colors we can select are the background and accent colors, which is why in my mind, I keep my mindset as background one is my main background color. It's simpler, easier for me to think of it that way. I could click on OK to save this theme. However, I want to set up the other two themes now for the light tint and the darker shades of the colors. I can handle that right now. I'll click on the theme dropdown and select Create New Theme. With this, I'm going to use all five colors of the light palette that I created, not worrying as much about the font color. Now I'll do the dark theme. I'll click on the OK button to save all three of my palettes. I can now remove the palettes from the canvas in the medium bin as I don't need them anymore. Whoops! I did forget to set the fonts for the themes. Yep, with the themes, once the font is set, no more having to scroll through a ton of fonts each time. Let's go back in, File, Manage Themes, and set the fonts by clicking on the Font tab. Once again, font 1 will be the font that is automatically or immediately used when the theme is selected. If you select a second font to use for your videos, it should be significantly different from the first font. You don't want to use two fonts side by side that are so similar they are hard to distinguish from each other. A significant difference can add interest to the design of your videos. Let me go ahead and change the font on the other two themes. Then click OK. From this point, using the theme is relatively straightforward. Put an annotation on the canvas and in your properties panel at the very top, select your theme to make automatic changes. Now, what if you wanted to use a different background color? Simply go down to the drop-down for the shape fill and select the theme and a different color for the background. The theme selection at the top of the annotations panel is automatic, and that's set in your theme. And the individual drop-downs are your manual settings, so if you want to change the color from what is set in the theme, you can change it to any individual color of your choosing. If you want to change the font to your second theme font, simply select a theme, and the two fonts will appear for you to select from. Of course, you can always manually use a different color or adjust a color using the color bar or moving the color picker here. If you find you like a color a little better and you won't prefer that in your theme, just copy the hex code by highlighting it and pressing Ctrl plus C. Click on the drop down for the color and the theme selection. Click on Manage Themes, select the theme, the color drop down you want to change, and paste in the new hex code with Ctrl plus V. What is great about using themes is you could have several callouts on a track, and you could change the colors all at once by highlighting them all, then selecting the theme or manually selecting a color. As I mentioned earlier, a few annotations that do not have the automatic color selection are the lines, arrows, and drawing annotations. Those are usually your accent colors that you had set. Those you will select directly from the drop-down theme menus. Here are a couple bonus workflow tips. If you have annotations you constantly use outside of your normal theme setup, for instance, a text box with a specific color and with a border, set one up, then save it in your library. This way you do not have to bother with constantly selecting an annotation, the color of the box, the color of the font, and the border color and size. Simply open the library, select and drag the saved annotation onto the canvas, and change the text. The second workflow tip is, unfortunately, themes cannot be shared amongst workstations. If you collaborate with others on a team with multiple workstations, simply open a Camtasia 2018 theme template and take a snapshot with Snagit of the color tab and the font tab. Save those images to your Camtasia library because libraries can be shared. Then all your team members need to do is open the theme images and create themes within their Camtasia 2018 using the color eyedropper to select the colors from the image.
Now you can see you can create a multitude of color palettes for your own YouTube channel or your clients' videos or for specific one-time only video projects. So if you liked this video on Camtasia 2018 themes, you may like to watch one of my other training videos. So remember to subscribe and leave a comment below. I am constantly taking requests and learning from your feedback on what you would like to learn. So until we meet again, have a wonderful day.